I could have done it. I mean, he was right there. It would have been so easy. He'd never have even seen it coming. Yeah, I could have killed him. And really, who would blame me? The guy was a maniac. He had been chasing me for a really long time. He wanted to kill me. Yeah, I could have done it, but I didn't. Look, all I'm saying is there are just some things you don't do. There's a fair way to play, and then there are things that are completely out of bounds. Like lying, cheating, killing. Yeah, way out of bounds. I've been on this road for a long time. Maybe you've heard of me. I'm the guy who killed Goliath. Yeah, that was a good day. I'm also the guy who God has chosen to be the next king of Israel. But for now, I'm on the run for my life. I spend most of my time traveling throughout the desert looking for any good place to hide. It's been this way for a while, and there's no end in sight. So yeah, killing Saul would have made my life a whole lot easier. And maybe no one would have blamed me after all that's happened. Maybe no one would have even had to know. But I would know, and God would know. Okay, so you seem a little confused. Let me try to explain. This all really began when Samuel the priest came to my hometown and anointed me as the next king of Israel. Then, God helped me win all these other battles, and he even helped me defeat Goliath. Well, when Saul found out about this, he went over the edge. He's been trying to kill me ever since. I keep moving so he doesn't get that opportunity. So get this, a while back, I was hiding in this cave with some of the guys that were on the run with me. We had recently heard that Saul and his army were in the area. That's right, now it's not only the king of Israel who wants to kill me, but he has 3,000 of his most elite troops with him. So anyways, we were hiding out in the cave like normal one day, when all of a sudden, Saul walks in. No kidding. Of all the hiding places and all the caves in the entire desert, Saul picks mine to, well, relieve himself. I mean, what are the odds of that? Then one of my men came up behind me and told me this was my chance, that I should sneak up on him, kill him, and put an end to this madness so we could all go home. I took action. I used my best stealth skills, I stayed low, and I crept up right behind him. I was so close, I could almost hear him breathing. At one point, I thought he was going to say something, as though he had caught on to me. But he didn't, and I closed the gap between us. Then, I pulled out my knife, I cut him. Okay, so I didn't cut him, I cut his robe, to prove that I could have cut him, that I could have killed him, if I wanted to. And yeah, a part of me really wanted to. Instead, I let him walk right out of the cave, and I followed after him, calling his name. When he heard me, he turned around and saw me waving his robe in the air. He seemed pretty blown away. He said I was cool and all for not killing him, and then he just took his men and he left. But that's just Saul. He's crazy like that. I knew within a day or two he'd be back to his killer king ways. So my men and I just hung out in the cave for 2 or 3 weeks, and sure enough, we heard that he was on the chase, again, and that he wanted to kill me, again. So we found out where his camp was, and we went down and snuck out there in the middle of the night. When we got there, Saul and his army were completely asleep. All of a sudden, I found myself standing over him, as though he had no idea that I was there. He was completely clueless. And then I realized this was my chance, again. And yeah, I could have. It really would have been so easy, but I didn't. You see, whether I agree with Saul or not, whether I think he's a complete nut or not, killing him was not the right thing to do. At the end of the day, I want to be a man of integrity. That means being who I say I am, even when no one's watching, even when everyone's sound asleep. So no, I didn't kill him. I took Saul's water jug and his sword instead. Heck, they were the easiest things to grab. Then my friends and I went to the top of the nearest hill and called down to the camp. When they woke up, I held the sword and the water jug just to show how close I'd gotten to the king. When Saul saw the jug, he realized that I could have killed him, again. But I didn't, again. Then he was all nice again and acted like I was his son or something. And then he left. Do I trust Saul? No way. Will he change his mind and come after me again? Probably. I know a lot of people might have done things a little different. A lot of people think I'm crazy for letting my wannabe killer go, not once, but twice. But at the end of the day, I have to live with the decisions that I make. At the end of the day, it's between me and God. So I choose to be a man of integrity and trust God with the rest. I'm David, and that's my story.